For years, you saved for this trip. To ski the Alps was your greatest dream. But it turned into a nightmare.
She won for us. She walked to save us.
Thank you. Hey, hold up there, stranger. What's your business? This is no weather for backpacking. These mountains aren't safe. Well, a blizzard knocked down several electrical poles and the power's out. Yeah, I saw the avalanche. Just like the one 5 years ago. I'm Otto. I live here at the ski resort. Well, you can use a resort to warm up, but if I were you, I'd move along soon. Well, trust me when I tell you, it's no place to stay.
Thank you. Welcome to the Alpine Resort. My name is Greta. I'm the manager here. The avalanche ruined our tourist business. I'm so glad you braved the weather to see the sights. I thought it was just going to be me and Otto for the week. He's an odd one. His parents thought the mountain air would cure him, but don't let his manner put you off. I'd offer the use of our phone, but the line is dead. That was quite a snowstorm we had. But we can fix it, if you don't mind pitching in. The tools are in the closet.
Thank you. Greta, it's me, Craig. You must listen to me. As police chief, I order you to evacuate immediately. Your possessions are not worth your life. Do you hear me? Get out of the village. Conditions are ripe for a devastating avalanche. It's going to be big.
Message saved on February 17th, 2007. The number you are dialing from no longer exists.
A message from Craig? I wouldn't worry about that. He's so melodramatic. Everything's an emergency with him. Leaving so soon. Why not stay and enjoy the resort? We have so much to offer. But if you insist, very well. The best way out of here is by snowmobile. There's a man, Peter is his name, who lives nearby. A very good carpenter he is. He uses a snowmobile to forage for wood in the mountains. He might let you borrow it.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm Peter. Greta must have sent you. Does she need more mannequins? I'd be careful with that lady. She'll sell your hide for a shiny knick-knack. Why leave this wintry paradise when you just got here? Some people dream their whole lives about a vacation in the Alps. My wife loved it here, but this is no time for a trip down memory lane. Yeah, you can use my snowmobile. It's in the shed. Here's the key. Good luck. You're gonna need it. Yeah, you can use my snowmobile. Thank you.
Hey, I heard someone calling for help. Someone locked you in Peter's shed. How bizarre. But then again, I have my suspicions about Peter. Folks here say he left his wife for a younger woman. But if it wasn't Peter, who was it? Maybe there's someone else here. Maybe someone followed you down from the summit.
Oh, the door must have locked behind you. It happens. The wind in these mountains changes like the mood of a woman. Clearly, I miss my wife. I thought I'd fix that snowmobile. I guess the parts need replacing. Hey, I've already done enough by lending you my snowmobile. Maybe Schultz can help you. He's over there, on the other side of the lake. I bet the battery's low. You might check the steering ski and motor chain, too.
You look worried, stranger. What's wrong? Ah, the snowmobile. That was inhospitable of Peter not to help you fix it. And you were locked in the shed. How odd. Visiting Schultz is a fine idea, though. He's a good mechanic. But his shop is in the village, and it's dangerous there now. The shop roofs are loaded down with snow from the avalanche. They could collapse any minute. Besides, the weather reports all say there's another blizzard on the way. You should stay here. You'd be taking your life into your hands if you tried to cross the lake now.
Thank you.
Wait a second. I heard you're going to try to get to the village. Someone's watching us. Just keep walking. I'll wait for you at the bridge. Listen, I know Greta just wants you to stay, but I'll help you. After the avalanche, the police blocked all the roads leading from the resort, but I tried to leave on foot, and I couldn't. Something's holding us here. Something tells me you can leave, if you try. You're my ticket out of here. This is Greta's boathouse. There's an airboat here. I knew she wouldn't give you the key, so I found it myself. Trust me, I'll help keep you here. I mean, I'll help get you out of here.
this wintry paradise when you just got here.
Leaving so soon.
Hey, hold up there, stranger.
Hello.
How did you get here?
I didn't think there were any other survivors. Yes, I'm Schultz. Have we met before? I've got snowmobile parts in my store. The only way to get there now is by ski lift. But the ski lift stations aren't working. You might be able to start them again from the control tower.
Thank you. Thank you.
You've reached the mountaintop where the upper station is. Welcome to my shop. You've reached the mountaintop. Oh, I didn't realize the store was locked. I can't find my key. I might have left it in the pocket of my other ski suit. Or I could have dropped it. I guess you better help me find it. I'll look in the forest. You check the ski run. It figures I'd drop it on the ski run. I hope your snowboard descent was exhilarating. I don't know what you mean about seeing dead people. That's just odd. but I'm glad you found my camera. It's a fine camera.
And on it are images I took just as the avalanche hit.
The battery's low. You can recharge it at the meteorological station. There's a computer there. Getting to the station could be a bit tricky, though. You'll have to head through the forest over the mountaintop. Follow the path. It zigzags around. Go right, then left, then straight for a bit, then another right, and another left. It's my camera, so it must be my fault. You say there was an explosion? I wanted the ultimate thrill, to ski the crest of an avalanche. I'm to blame. There was no explosion. If there was an explosion, where's your evidence? Do you have a photo of that? What a relief to know it wasn't my fault. The guilt was killing me. Please go on and repair your snowmobile. Help yourself to parts in my store. Oh, but the battery's low. Unfortunately, there's only one place in town to charge it, and that would be the Ice Sculpture Gallery.
There's a powerful generator there.
Greta helped finance that gallery. Ask her how to get in.
It's a shame, but my ice sculpture gallery never opened to the public. If we get it ready and open, it'll attract guests to the resort. But I don't know how to get there anymore. The avalanche buried that part of town. Talk to Otto. He was our pyrotechnics guy. I think he found a way in after the avalanche.
Hello again. You're looking for Otto? He's in the church.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm sorry. I had some business at the post office, and it's near the gallery, so I followed you. I knew you were looking for a way to the gallery. I want to send a letter to my family, but I guess we can't get through. The generator is empty. There's a gas station in the square, to the left of the church.
What you doing here? Looking for something? Gas? Good luck. The gas station is blocked by snow. But maybe a little noise would help your case. Avalanches are caused by vibration, after all. There's an organ in the church, I'm just saying.
Over and over, I send letters to my family, and they never respond. I'm sick and tired of living without them. Oh, why? Oh, why did I ever leave them? I'm such a fool. We all are. You're my family now. You and Otto and Greta. One big happy family. I wrote all those letters and I never got a reply. See for yourself. Go to the post office and look at my mailbox. It's empty. I can't believe it. My family never forgot me. They looked for me. Thank you so much. I understand now. But you can still leave. Get into that gallery and use the generator there. I hope you make it.
Wait, stranger. Don't leave yet. Look, the gallery still works. Now we'll get tourists. The village will have a whole new life. You can't have new life where everyone's dead. What do you mean by that? What a strange thing to say, really. Oh, don't go. You'll love it here. Wait till you see the ice show. Oh, don't go. My medallion. I'm never without it. I don't like what you keep seeing. I don't like it at all. I had big dreams for this place. People would come from all over. And now look at it. You might as well leave. There's nothing left. Otto might have some gas, but I doubt he'd give it to you. Here, take this key. It's to his room.
Well, well, so our newcomer is a little thief. You steal secrets, and your way into other people's houses. Whatever, soon everyone will know about you. That's hilarious. I'm dead? You kill me with your humor. That's why I'm dead. Alrighty then. If I'm so dead, I'll just blow up this canister. It won't hurt me, right? I mean, since I'm dead and all.
No way. It can't be. I thought those were just dreams. All that glorious fire raging up. I killed everyone. It was me. Fine. If that's who I am, so be it. Take your precious gas and get out of here. You're not like me. You're free.